Hello, everybody. How are you doing today? My name is Tony Rizzano. This is another episode of the world famous, the universal love, the best podcast in 1, 2, 3 galaxies. Ladies and gents, you and I, we just called this show Online Marketing Moves, and we are coming to you live today. Ladies and gentlemen, we are somewhere in Georgia. I don't quite know where. I'm not as young as I used to be. I can't remember every city I go to now. So today, as you folks know, I bought a truck last week. And I started running up and down, back down from Atlanta to Savannah, hauling stuff. And so today I just wanted to see, you know, I didn't go home. I just wanted to see where I can get to with a full, you know, day of work. And I got pretty far. I left one place, went up to Atlanta, came back to Savannah, picked up another container. Now I'm about, you know, 3 hours away from Atlanta. So I've done pretty good today. Tomorrow I'm just going to drive to Atlanta, deliver my load, and then go home for a few hours, you know. See my wife, see my baby, and then Saturday morning, probably come back, pick up a load, and then run it back to Atlanta, and be home Saturday afternoon, Sunday, and then get started Monday. Because the goal every week is to generate, you know, over $3,000, $4,000, $5,000 a week, something like that. But you know, the thing I wanted to talk about was, even though I am, you know, I used to work nights and do the podcast and all this other stuff, you know, and I bought a truck. But as I told my wife today, because we was talking about, because my wife and I, we want to focus more on doing, you know, I want to focus on, you know, podcasting, copywriting, things of that nature. And my wife wants to do more like load brokering. She wants to start booking loads and giving loads out to people. So I told her I would help her out. So, and this is the reason why we bought the truck. So that way we can get started. You know, you can build, because you always got to have a base. So I told my wife, I said, it'd be better if we start with the truck. We start generating some money, and then we can take that money and put it towards the brokering, you know, the load brokering. And so we're going to get that ball rolling. And, you know, I'm going to, you know, me myself, I want to focus on that, the load brokering part, but I also want to keep doing the podcast, making the podcast better. You know, I want to do other podcasts. I have ideas about, as I told you last week, information about truck driving. I'm going to do that. I have plans, you know. Now I just have to, now the most important thing is the time management, you know what I mean? I don't want to waste a lot of time, you know, a lot of, you know, fluidity. I want to, you know, have stuff out, start doing stuff, you know, quick, you know. So I'm in the truck now. I told my wife I'll probably spend one night on the road, maybe two at the most. You know, not too much, but when I am away from home, I need to be productive. You know what I mean? So, I got to map out a plan. But what I want to talk about today was, you know, just because you do something different, you know, sometimes the path that you want to go on is not a straight arrow, you know. Sometimes you have to avert. Sometimes you have to go the other way, go around. It's like my mom was talking to me today about this story, and she said, you know, your uncle, he went all around the world to get to the point. And I said, it happens sometimes, you know. People tell stories and they go around to get to the point, you know. And it's the same as your business. It's the same as whatever you want to do, you know. You might have to divert. You might have to do different things. You might have to get an extra job. You might have to work a job you don't like. You might have to work a, you know, you might have to work a part-time job. You might have to do whatever. But the But the main focus you should always have is the, not the goal, but just the journey itself, you know. It's frustrating, it's tough sometimes, but it's like, all right, I know I can get there. Why do I tell you this? Because, you know, by now, I thought by now I'd be a full-fledged, you know, writer and all this kind of stuff. But, you know, things happened. I had family, you know, things I had to take care of that popped up, you know. Had a baby, you know, that was, I knew that. I always laugh because I always think the first time that my wife, she had to go back to work because she owned a business and everybody was, you know, it was like mutiny on a bounty. Everybody was, I need more money. So she had to go back, you know. It was an emergency. So I understand that completely. And the first day I spent I was really with the baby alone, you know, and it was like the first week. And I was like, you know what, I'm going to write while the baby sleep, you know. And so it was in the morning, and the baby was sitting next to me sleeping. And, you know, she had a milk, and she was sleeping. And I said, all right. And I got three sentences down. And I guess she said, nah, you ain't doing nothing today. Ah! And started screaming. And I remember later on, she went back to sleep for a nap. And I said, okay, now I'm going to write. Because I had to go. Had to go feed my mother-in-law. Had to come back. I said, okay, the baby sleep. And, you know, I wrote down another sentence. And I said, oh, this ain't going to work. You know, so I said, you know what? For the next year, I just can't, you know. Because I wanted to spend the first year, you know, just with my child, you know. Because you can't get that back, you know. And so I don't have any regrets with that, you know. I don't have any complaints about that. But all this time, you know, in my mind, I'm like, all right, I'm going to get back to writing. And here we are, you know, I'm doing a podcast, I'm talking to you. And today when I was driving, I started thinking about these ideas. I said, okay, it's time, you know. We're going to write fast, you know. We're going to get to the point where before I would write, I would sort of edit myself, but I'm like, I want the writing to be better. I want to get better. I want to improve. So I'm going to go on Upwork, Fiverr, whichever one, find somebody to edit the stuff I write, you know, so they can send it back to me. I can look at it, you know, because the thing is, it's not about perfection, but you want the stuff to be good. You want the stuff to be seen, you know. And that's what I'm telling you about the podcast yesterday. I know the other day I said, you know, hey, man, we got to get better, you know. You got to improve. You got to see some, because, you know, we've done 500-something episodes, you know. I've done enough episodes. I've had plenty of practice, you know. I probably had, I don't know how many hours. You know, I know they have, it's a book out. It's like 10,000 hours of perfection, something like that. I don't know if I had 10,000 hours, but I'm getting pretty close. And you know, it's been 2 years, 3 years, and I'm like, all right, now it's time to turn up the volume, turn up the heat when it comes to, you know, podcasting, marketing, copywriting, you know, the load brokering. It's time to turn up the heat, you know, because as I told my wife, I said, 6 months, I'm going to drive this truck. I'm going to work this truck, you know. And eventually, I want to find somebody to drive it. We can split the cost or whatever, you know. But until then, I had to do it, you know. Because I was telling my wife, I said, you know, I traded one job for another. This is a business, don't get me wrong. But it's still a job, you know, because if I don't drive the truck, I don't get paid, you know. And so I want to get to the point where, because I still make a few pennies, you know, off some of the stuff that I wrote on Medium, you know. And I'm like, hey, man, I wrote that a year ago, and I can see like 5 cents, 10 cents, you know. Hey, man, that ain't much, but, you know, it's something. It lets you know, like, hey, you, the first time you get paid for anything, you're like, hey, man, I'm a paid whatever, you know. I told myself, I said, all right, I'm a paid writer. The first month that I wrote a Medium, I got a check for like a dollar or something like that. And I said, you know what? It's fine with me. I'm a paid writer. And you can't take that away from me, you know? And so we're going to get back to that. We're going to get back to everything. And so I just wanted to tell you, hey, man, woman, the journey is not always straight, the straight path, you know? And sometimes, for some, like my wife, she knew she wanted to be a chef. She went to culinary school. My homeboy, he went from the Navy. I remember I used to get off a 12-hour shift, and he would be in the back baking. He would be in the back of the kitchen baking stuff, and he's like, "Yeah, this is what I'm gonna do with myself," you know. And I'm like, "That's cool." And I remember he got out. He went to culinary. You know, he went to school in New York, and then he went to Kansas to bake and learn about the science of baking. And, you know, before you know it, now he owns a donut shop and he's been doing it for 15 years. And I'm like, you know, I admire them because they knew what they were doing. Me, when I got out of high school, I didn't really know which path I wanted to go on. I didn't know what I was going to do. You know, and it took me a long time to figure, you know, things out. Figure out stuff that I actually wanted to do, you know. And that's okay, you know. I'm not... Because I had to think, you know, at first you like, I should have done this a long time ago. But you have to think about it. Sometimes God puts you in places that he knows you need to be in, you know. Maybe at the time, you know, writing when I was 25 wasn't right for me, you know. But I found the writing bug, you know, again at the age of 37, 38, you know. And here we are, you know. It's, you know, I started writing a lot. You know, got a little interrupted. Never let it go. You know, I still write stuff down, still jot stuff, still have... I have plenty of pieces of paper with ideas on there. I'm like, I got to flush them out, you know, flesh them out and get to it. And so I'm just telling you, you know, that no matter what, there's nothing that can stop you, you know? You know, I get... it's always funny when I watch my daughter, you know? The walking thing. She went from, you know, she... didn't really want to crawl at first. She would stand up, you know, sort of stand up, try to stand up, fall down, you know. She would stand up and fall down. Then I remember a couple of times she got on, she crawled, but she would crawl in reverse. And my wife was like, I don't know what she's going to do, you know. And this is about a month before her birthday she was doing this. And now if you fast forward to like 2 months later, my daughter, she's walking fast. It's hard to keep up with her, you know. She's walking to the fireplace. You'll say, come on, you know, come on. And she'll just start wobbling. She won't fall down as much, you know. And as many times as she fell, and my wife was like, I'm like, she all right, you know. She gonna keep coming back, you know. I was like, she's our child, you know. She's tough. And it's funny to watch. And it's like, you know, if a baby... Babies don't know. Babies have just instinct. The instinct is just to keep getting back up, you know. And it's the same for you, you know. It's like, why would you stop the dream, you know? Why would you stop whatever you have, the goal you have, the desire you have, the passion that you have, you know, for whatever you want to do? Why stop that just because, oh, this happened, that happened, you know? Hey, man, if you're walking down the street and you really want to go to the store, you're really hungry, and a bunch of bricks just fall right in the path, what are you going to do? You're either going to walk around them bricks, climb over them bricks, you know? Or if you're Superman, you'll just bowl right through the bricks. But the point is, you're going to go around because you're hungry, and you're going to get to your destination. And that's the point of all this. You're going to walk around. You might have to walk around. For some of us, some of you, you're going to go straight to the path. Some of us, we're going to walk all the way around and then get to the path. But the point is, don't ever stop believing, you know? That's the worst thing you can do is stop. Stop believing, all right? So, ladies and gentlemen, that is my TED Talk for the evening. We'll be back tomorrow with the all-new episode of Online Marketing Moves. But until then, my name is Tony Rizzano. Thank you for listening. And as always, everybody, peace.